Happy day, students. In today's class, we are going to see electrostatic potential. Okay, as we discussed in the previous class about electrostatic potential energy, same way we have to discuss electrostatic potential. So what is potential? Before going into the potential at a particular point, we will discuss about potential difference. Okay, so first of all, electrostatic potential we are going to represent with V. Okay, a scalar quantity, just like potential energy. Okay, it's also a scalar quantity. Okay, potential energy also was scalar. Its unit was joule, but electrostatic potential, its unit is volt. We all know that. Okay, but other than that, if I am going to define it, the potential difference is actually equal to potential energy difference per unit charge. Potential difference is equal to potential energy difference per unit charge. That means delta U by Q. Okay, now what was delta Q? And delta Q actually was minus of work done by electrostatic force by Q. Okay, let's come to this part, work done by electrostatic force. Now, if you remember that, work done by electrostatic force, in that one we said that if there is a charge Q and another charge, I am keeping a small q. Okay, then electrostatic force is doing what? It is going to ripple. If suppose this is fixed here, then this capital Q is going to ripple this small q because that's free. When it's rippling it, it will ripple it to a point where this force is going to become zero. Okay, till the point the force is there, it is continuing to ripple it. When it will stop ripping it? When the force becomes zero, and that position is infinity. Right? At infinity, the force becomes zero, and we say potential energy also becomes zero at infinity. We have seen that, right? So work done by electrostatic force, if I am writing it over here, this is minus 1 by Q over here. Okay. Electrostatic force, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Qq by R square into dr. Yes or no? Correct. So take out all the constant terms and you see that this Q and this Q gets cancelled. So what we have? Minus Q by 4 pi epsilon naught dr by R square. Dr by R square, its integration gives us minus 1 by R. So minus 1 by R. From where to where we are going? From where to where we are going? From R to infinity. Yes or no? Correct? So, here we are getting what? We are going to place the values. This is Q by 4 pi epsilon naught. Okay? 1 by infinity minus 1 by R. Okay? So, what are we getting as a potential here? Potential we are getting as Q by 4 pi epsilon naught R. This is Q by 4 pi epsilon naught R. This is the potential. At what position? At this position. Okay. Is that clear? This is delta V. Okay. But in this case also, we have taken here what? One position is infinity and one position is R. So we are writing here. V at infinity minus V at R. So V at infinity, again, potential energy at infinity is zero. So potential also at infinity is zero. So this is zero. So, 0 minus Vr equal to this value. I think this is negative, I guess. Yeah. This is negative. So, equal to minus Q by 4 pi epsilon naught R. So, what is the value of Vr we are getting? It's positive Q by 4 pi epsilon naught R. This is the potential when the difference between two charges, Q and Q, is R. And whose potential is that? It's a potential of Q charge at this position. That means potential is a property of a single charge. It's not a property of the system. Potential energy is a property of the system because in that one you add 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 by R or 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q Q by R. Okay? Potential energy is defined for a system, whereas potential is property of a single charge. That's why it is defined as potential energy per unit charge. Okay? Is that clear? Same way, if you see that similar kind of a relation is there between force and electric field. Force between two charges, we write Q1, Q2 by R square. But when we say field of charge Q1, we said that force per unit charge. That means it is a property of a single charge, not of two charges. Do you understand that? The same kind of relation is there between potential energy and potential. Potential energy is a property of a single charge. Potential energy is of the system. Okay. So, how to define it? What definition will be given in the books? Particularly for CBSE, what definition will be writing? One definition I told you already, work done by electrostatic force in moving the charge from the separation arc to infinity. But in books it is given, work done. Okay, work done by electrostatic force on a unit positive charge. Unit positive charge. That means, instead of Q, we directly place here plus 1. A unit positive charge, a test charge. Okay, if a test charge we are going to keep take from R to infinity, what will happen is, this Q we are not going to write at all, because this Q becomes 1. Okay, this Q here is 1, this Q here is 1. Same answer will come. But the definition they say is, work done by electrostatic force in moving a unit positive charge from a position to infinity is equal to negative of potential. Understood that? Understood that? Okay. But we are defining it as, it is actually delta V equal to delta U by Q. Okay. So what formula we got for potential? Q by 4 pi epsilon naught R. Let's see further. So, if suppose we have a single charge only and we have to find potential, can we find it? Answer is yes. If a Q1 is here and I want to find its potential at point P at a distance x, can I find its potential? Yes, obviously. That will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 by x. But if suppose Q1 is negative, then potential will be negative. V is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught minus Q1 by x. Just like potential energy, potential also can be positive as well as negative. As I told you, in potential energy, suppose that the force is attraction between two charges, potential energy will be negative. If the force is repulsive, potential energy will be positive. Here is also the same case. Here is also, we will have, if suppose here is positive 1. So what this is going to do? It is going to attract it. So potential is negative. If this is positive, this is going to repel plus 1. So potential is positive. Okay? See here this relation that we started from, delta V equal to delta U by Q. So another unit of potential is there. Delta U's unit is joule. And Q's unit is coulomb. Okay, so unit of potential is also joule per coulomb. 1 joule per coulomb, 1 joule by 1 coulomb is actually volt. Okay, is actually volt. So both the values, both the units we need to remember. Okay, and one more thing, like you will be getting at many places, there will be questions that one charge has been moved from one potential to other potential, then how much is the work done? Okay, so see over here, we already have written delta V is equal to delta U by Q. So that means delta U is actually what? Q delta V. Yes or no? Yes. And we also know that this delta U is actually negative of work done by electrostatic force. So questions actually asked from you is, find the work done by electrostatic force if the charge is moved from one potential to other potential. Let's say, if I say that here potential is 20 volt, here potential is 10 volt, and 2 coulomb charge, we are moving from 20 volt to 10 volt. What is the work done by electrostatic force? Fine. Okay, so work done by electrostatic force will be minus Q delta V. Okay. Further, minus Q into V final minus V initial. That means this is Q into V initial minus V final. That means this is 2 coulomb, V initial 20 volt, initial and final 20 volt, 10 volt.
So 2 into 20 minus 10.
Our answer is 20 joule. Okay, very common these kinds of questions. These kinds of questions are asked, so you need to remember this formula, or this formula is very, very important. Okay, so one formula is this, another formula that we got is absolute potential of any point, that is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r. But remember always, that is the value of potential only when we consider that potential at infinity is 0. Same for potential energy also. If you want to find potential energy at any point, you need to consider a reference. And our reference is at infinity, potential energy is 0. Okay.
So this is the basic about potential. Okay. Let's see further how to find potential in a system. Okay. See. Now potential is a scalar quantity. Remember that. So now, if suppose any simple questions are, if we do, let's say this is Q1 charge here and here is a Q2 charge, both are positive, and the separation between them is D, and I want to find what is the potential in the middle.
Okay. Potential in the middle. Okay. So D by 2, what will happen? Potential is having direction. So are we going to subtract them? Answer is no. Potential is a scalar quantity. We have to add it. So potential due to Q1 at P, let's say V1, is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 by D by 2, not square, square means electric field. So potential, so Q by R, so Q1 by D by 2. Potential due to Q2, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q2 by D by 2. Okay, total potential. V1 plus V2. What's going to be? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, you can take common. And this D by 2, you can take this 2 up, it will become 2 by D. Here also 2 by D. So take it common. 2 by D. What is inside? Q1 plus Q2. If anything is minus, if suppose Q2 is minus, we'll put minus over here. Okay, so here also minus will come. So that's how we add potentials. Okay? Because of two quantities, what is going to be the potential at particular place, we have to find like this. Okay, let's do further. Let's understand what the potential is. Okay, so suppose three charges I am going to keep at the vertex of an equilateral triangle this time. So it's like this. This is Q1, this is Q2, this is Q3, this is A. Okay, and at the centroid, I want to find the potential, right? So potential will be because of Q1 also, because of Q2 also, because of Q3 also. But only thing I have to find is what is the distance. And I told you that this is actually A by root 3. So we have to remember it, right? Okay. So potential I am writing directly, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, first because of Q1, so Q1 by A by root 3, then because of Q2, Q2 by A by root 3, plus Q3 by A by root. This is a potential. If anything is negative, we'll put the negative charge, okay? And then we have to add. There's no doubt about that, okay? So don't get confused in that. If the charge is negative, put it. No problem. Right. Now see, if suppose there are two charges, Q and minus Q, okay? And the middle, I want to find the potential. Suppose this is R and this is also R. Will it be 0? Will it be 0 or not 0? 0. But is electric field 0 there? This is positive, this is negative. If suppose I have to find electric field, what I will do? I'll put plus 1 coulomb over here. See that this Q is going to repel it or attract it? Repel it. Repel it means direction will be this. What about this minus Q? Minus Q is going to attract it. So that means direction will be this. That means electric field is not 0 at the middle. And since it's positive and negative charge, we know that electric field will be 0 where? Outside the line joining two charges. Yes or no? Correct or not? Okay. So in between, electric field will not be 0. So I have written electric field is not 0, but potential is 0 here. So what is important point in this one, there are certain places where electric field will be 0, but potential will not be 0. okay? Some places will be there where potential is zero, but electric field is not zero. Both will be zero at infinity for sure, but at other places, it will be difficult to find both electric field and potential zero. So be aware of that. Don't write that potential is zero, so electric field is also zero, or vice versa. Be careful. Okay? Alright. So this is how we can find out the potential due to point charges. Okay. Many charges also we have used. Single charges also we have used. Now, I am going to find potential due to uniformly charged objects, as we did in the case of electric field also. Okay. So let's see. Potential due to uniformly charged objects. So first, let's take rod only. Okay. First is rod. Okay. What this rod is, let's see. So if this is the rod, okay, and its linear charge density is same lambda coulomb per meter, and its length is L, and suppose I want to find its potential at point P, where the distance is x, right? What we have to do? Again, take a small part. Because of small part, we are going to find, and then we are going to integrate, because we are following Coulomb's law. So Coulomb's law is defined only for point charges. So here also we are going to take very small points so that it can represent as a point. Okay, so here is some charge. Let's say dq is the charge. Its length we are deciding as, what shall you take? Take this as r. Okay, distance from dq to that point is r. So here that small separation, obviously we will be taking as dr only. Okay. So let me write the potential at point P due to dq. Formula says it is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught dq by r. The question is, what is dq? What will be dq? Dq will be linear charge density into length of that small portion, that is lambda dr. Put it over here. 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught lambda dr by r. I have integrated from where to where? So minimum value of r possible, that means the distance between the charge and that point. Minimum distance is what? X. Because the charge can come over here, then only this distance will be minimum. Then what is the maximum distance between charge and this point P? Where the charge will be here. That is x plus L. So here is x and here is x plus L. So what are we getting? This is lambda by 4 pi epsilon naught. This is log of r. So log of x plus L by x. Right or not? This is the potential due to uniformly charged rod. Okay. Same way, we can find it for other objects also. What are the other objects? Let's see. We can take it for a ring. Okay. So what will be the potential due to ring? At its center, let's say first. Okay, so for ring, at its center, this is the ring, this is the center we are talking, radius is r you can say, and linear charge density again, lambda coulomb per meter, correct or not? Method is same only. What I am going to do, I will be taking one small element in that. Take the small element, this is the small element. Okay, that's dq, right? And let's assume this is theta, so this will be d theta. Okay, so because of this at the center, what is the potential? Potential at C is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught dq by r. Now, is r variable here? No, because every point, every charge on this ring is at same distance r from the center. So r is not variable here. Okay. Then what is dq? Again, lambda into length of that small section. What is the length of this small section here? R d theta? Yes or no? Put it over there. So 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught lambda r d theta by r. R gets cancelled. Okay, now do we have to take the components of the potential over here because it's inclined? No, potential is a scalar quantity. You don't have to take components of potential. Okay, potential is not a vector quantity. Again, I am saying. So, potential's components will not be taken. Okay, so this is it. Now, we have to integrate it. Now, theta, if I start my element from here, from this point, then theta will be 0. Then, this element I can take up to this point over here. So, what is the angle? This angle, total angle, 360. So, this is 2 pi r. Rather, 2 pi. Okay, so what we are getting? Lambda by 4 pi epsilon naught here. D theta is integration theta. Putting limits 2 pi and 0. What we are going to get? 2 pi. Okay, so we are going to get lambda 2 pi by 4 pi epsilon naught. Right? You can cancel this one. So final answer is lambda by 2 epsilon naught. The potential at the center of the ring, uniformly charged ring, is lambda by 2 epsilon naught. Is that okay? That's all right now. Further potential, about potential, we'll see in our next class. Okay? Bye for now.